Good afternoon. My name is Hae Sun Kim, advisor of Gangnam Labor Law Firm. Today with labor attorney Jung Bong-su, we will cover the Labor Union Act, Article 15, which is the holding of general meetings. Mm-hmm. So could you explain about the procedure of holding or organizing general meetings?
Okay. Hello. How are you today? This is Bong-su Jung, Korean labor attorney. Regarding labor union operation, there are three main organizations. One is the operation team, like president, vice president, or general secretary, management team. Also, in the labor union, there are the general meetings. So this is like national assembly where lawmakers make they introduce new legislation, or they introduce a new law, for also they decide a kind of budget or important decision. So, yeah, something like we have a general meeting. Also audit in the labor union, there are also audit functions. So those three party, auditing, general meeting, or management team, they are three the big the powers in the labor union. So they are designed to make a union operated by democratic process. Yeah. So in this general meeting, labor union chairman can hold this general meeting at least once a year. Also by necessity, they can have some interim or some temporary general meetings. So what they do in general meeting is they make a very important decision about union the management, such as the introducing bylaw or operation rule. Also they decide also they elect union management teams. Also they decide whether they hold kind of the collective agreement or collective action. Yeah. Also they decide about budget and also the money spend planning. Also the general meeting will decide whether they join the umbrella union or not. Also in case the company has some organization change, then they'll decide whether union will operate their entity one or the divided entity. This is those part the union members they should decide in the general meeting. So general meeting is a very important the decision making process. So in order to make a decision, they must have a majority of union members participation. So in order to decide certain the decision, they have a pro and con vote. So when they have a majority the agreement, then this new agreement is decided. But in special case like the impeaching the union chairman, or the change of the operation rule, also some the organization change of the labor union, they must have two-thirds of agreement while the majority of union members participated. So it is required to have a very strict decision making process. Like very important decision must have more the majority, like two-thirds of all the participants. Yeah.
I see. So as you have explained, it's like Korea's National Assembly rules that in order to make an important decision, the majority of members has to attend the general meeting, and two-thirds has to agree.
Yeah.
So can you introduce some example of some cases that you have advised where the union members fail to agree on this
Yeah, I think it's a good question. Yeah, there are one case I supported the company for like 10 years ago. So this company was suffering from the deficit and they need to reduce the number of workers through managerial dismissal. So in legal requirement for managerial dismissal, company should the consult with the union union chairman, and they decide who will be target workers for managerial dismissal. So when they decide the criteria for choosing the target people, so company suggest a certain condition, then labor union at the time accepted what company suggested. So then because of the criteria, many labor union would be dismissed. So they worried, so they blamed this union chairman and tried to impeach the union chairman. So those people who belong to the target people, they get together and protest, and they try to impeach this union chairman. So they suggest some impeaching process to the union members. So majority of union members participated, and they voted in order to impeach this the current union chairman. So, but the result was the number has more than majority, but it could not meet 2/3 of the collective, I mean the positive vote. So they could not impeach this union chairman. So because of that, those people who belong to those criteria for manager dismissal voluntarily joined this ERP program, and they resigned and accepting 6 months additional pay, because they knew if they reject, they could not get any compensation. So at the time, so those some 2/3 of majority vote is very important. So I realized that so this legal process is very important in order to impeach union chairman. Yeah.
I see. So in case that the majority do not even the majority do not agree, but they impeach union chairman, is it a big penalty from the labor committee?
Or like if they could not get the 2/3 of the positive vote, they could not impeach this the contingent union chairman. So those people who belong to the target group for managed dismissal could not impeach this union chairman. That means company will dismiss them for manager reason. So at the time, they could not receive any ERP package. So they knew the only best way for them is to apply for the ERP program and resign voluntarily after receiving 6 months additional salary. So it was related to this voting requirement in the general meeting. Yeah,
I see. This article 15 is, I think, is very important. And thank you very much for your detailed explanation.
Okay, thank you for watching. Okay, bye bye.